Only Dick Vitale, myself, and the nation's best make it this far. Tonight's Elite Eight contest should prove to be a great one between the Eastern Washington Eagles and the Gonzaga Bulldogs. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Bulldogs are not facing one of their tougher opponents, so what's the key in them not giving it away?
Well, for me, the keys are these. First, play your game. It's up to the point guard to make certain that they stay in their game and they play at their pace. Next, hand the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if we can get their big man in foul trouble. Finally, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway.
Definitely worth another look, Brad.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
They work it around the perimeter. Number 34 with the ball. Gets a hand in the way, moving it around the perimeter. He pulls the trigger, off the rim and no good. He keeps his dribble as they reset. Number 25 takes the feed, way off target. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Number two is emotionally pumped up.
Well, he's had some success, and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now. Oh, we got to replay that one.
Pushes it up. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Trying to feed the low block. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Now looking to move it down court in a hurry. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Number one is pounded on his way up. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Second shot, no good. Now trying to feed the low block. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
The point guard takes the pass. He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good. Now the high screen. Trying to draw the foul. Number five makes the finger roll. It's a fast break possibility. Goes up for two. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. In the paint. Trying to draw some contact. Knocks it down.
Watch this!
Steal. Number five. Modest play is having a negative effect on his composure. Emotional. He couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
Hey, well, offensively, he's probably not feeling it. Defensively, he's been a step behind. He's going to have to turn things around. Ooh, look at a shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. With a deep shot from outside. Way off target.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Puts it up, looking for contact. And he scores despite the hack. Passed on the guy in the post to go the other way.
Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. And he'll kick it back outside. The center gets the ball. And that's going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Down inside. Entry pass in the paint. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. The crowd loves this young man.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick down on the sidelines. The losing team is starting to get a bit anxious. Their coaches can sense that, and they're telling their team to just relax. Could it be the bright lights that have this team second-guessing so far tonight, Brad?
Number 34 gets the pass. Perfectly executed. From right of the circle, he buries it from downtown.
Hey, tell me, we got a replay ready for that one, Brad?
Too many dribbles and a steal. Looking for contact. Gonzaga are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He tries the three ball, way off target. They go into the low block, tries for two.
Couldn't put it in off the screen inside. Tough luck.
This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Number 24, pump fakes. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Number two grabs it.
Great elevator man, man. That's the elevator guy. What a high riser.
On the outside. Number 42 is charged with the foul. First personal foul. And we'll go to the free throw line. He hits it. You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football special situations, you got to be able to execute there.
For two, can't get the shot to go. He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I'll tell you, great job by the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Cashed it in. And he got them both. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Transition opportunity coming up. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. There's the pick from left of the circle, off the rim and no good. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Steals a pass. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Goes up for two. The Bulldogs have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Circle.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though.
On the dribble, gives it up. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. In and out. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
In the paint, but went elsewhere. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Looking for a good shot. For two. And he missed. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
Let's see if it looks as good on the replay.
He's got a nice shot fake. Now they work it around the perimeter. From the top of the circle. He misses from the outside. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. The good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Stolen away. He gets the bucket to drop and gets the foul.
He felt the pressure on the way up, but managed to keep himself focused on the rim.
If his actions weren't deflating enough, how about this? He's definitely provoking this crowd.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's a no-no.
Number five steps to the line for the first time. Routine. I'm out. Back into action here. There they come with a double team to stop it.
Oh, what a strip, Red.
Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
This crowd will go crazy if they get a shot to go down here. Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Up. Easy one. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. And in and out. Opportunity for two for one. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Working it around the perimeter. He attempts the three. He shows the sweet touch. And the ball goes out of play. Number 25 picks up the foul. Second personal foul.
That spacing.
Tries for two. In and out. They're making the offense use every bit of that shot clock.
The offense looks a little confused out there. Brilliant D, baby.
And the end of the first half. The Eagles are ahead by five. It's been a tight battle so far, Dick. Do you have a highlight of the half in your book?
My highlight of the first half has to be this trifecta, Brad. It showed another one of the deadly weapons that this team has offensively. I expect more of that in the second half.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Gonzaga did a terrible job cleaning the glass in the first half.
How many times you and I hear coaches preach about the importance of rebounding the ball on both ends of the floor? I don't know where the players' minds are. Maybe they're thinking about their dates.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Controlling the ball. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great defensive play. Anticipating well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dumps it in. He pump fakes. Here's a double team, swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Defensively down to the low block, and there's a steal.
A terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Got the high pick. He puts it in with contact and all. Steals the ball.
Nobody getting back, Brad. Where's the defense?
They work it around the perimeter. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Basket falls despite the contact. They'll work it around the arc. Looking for the foul. The Bulldogs have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Gave it up. He lets it go. Drains the shot.
Sometimes you got to take that whipping, Brad.
Well, the D certainly is tonight.
Up and inside.
The small forward receives the ball. Can't seem to find the stroke from the arc, Dick.
And they're missing wide open looks too, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. He unloads a three. Off the rim and no good. For two.
I love the sky hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
They work the perimeter. He strokes it. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Now they work it around the perimeter. The center handles the feed. He couldn't get it to fall. Here's a drop step in the low block.
Very key is to get good post position, and he does, and then he drops the step.
He goes to the free throw line. First shot is good. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
Tremendous defensive effort. That forces a 5-second violation. That's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
So they'll inbound on the near sideline. leave it up. Great defense. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making the quarter long pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Moving it around the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Throws up the shot. Goes.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from right of the circle. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick TO, baby.
Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Takes it off him. From the top of the key. Way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. For two, the layup. For a good shot.
Up and inside.
Fakes it. Looking for a screen on top and got it. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there. Great play to take that to the basket.
Outside with the fake. Lobs it inside. He goes for the trifecta. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offense in transition.
He fires from long range. It's good. Working it around the perimeter. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Rims out. Goes out of bounds. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
The center receives the pass. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
The center handles the pass, using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop, takes the ball with a goal strong.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, this is what people wanted to see, a close championship game. The action and intensity has really picked up down here, guys. Everyone wants to see a great finish.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
They work it back to the outside. Picks off the lazy pass. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Gave it up. From beyond the arc. Off the rim and no good. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He shoots from left of the circle. Nice shot. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Number 5 is whistled for the foul. Oh, he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Dick, they're really going to have to monitor this because they've hit the bottom mentally. They're really going to be in some big, big trouble. The Eagles have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
The fake. He puts it up. Off the rim and no good. You better plug your ears if they get a basket on this possession. Work it inside and he tries a drop step and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Good fake. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
He shoots from left of the circle. The Bulldogs are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. He shoots. Rims out. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Look at that spacing.
For the deuce. Easy one. Almost lost the basketball. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He launches the bomb. Off the rim and no good.
Excellent excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The ball goes out of bounds. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
Picked out of the air. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Picks off the pass. He drains the bucket. Goes up for two. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
Aaron's right about that. Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so. I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. He takes the shot. Gets it to fall. The perimeter. Number four. He got the bucket and the foul.
Hey, the foul in the act couldn't stop him, baby. He wanted that bucket.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Number 15 to the line, shooting one. Makes the foul shot. Looking for a good shot. On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
I wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either. Inside.
He goes for three. He gets the bucket. He throws it deep. Now they work it around the perimeter. Got an open look if he wants it. And he's charged with his last foul.
They come too quick sometimes.
Well, Dick, what's the backcourt situation looking like to you?
I tell you, man, guard play is such a huge part of the college game. Can't win without great guard play. Backcourt play dictates your team's success. Their play must be steady, consistent. Controlling the tempo in a game, distributing the ball, scoring, and pressuring on a defensive end. They are all characteristics of having a solid tandem in a perimeter.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Well, here's a look at the turnover situation, Dick. Probably one of the stats that coaches really care about the most.
I'll tell you, definitely, Brad. Turnovers are missed shot opportunities. And without shot opportunities, winning games becomes really difficult.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. He misses the second.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one-possession game.
He unloads. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
He goes to the line. Makes it. He hits his second.
They really need a score here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Back to the live action we go. He tries the three, rims out.
Look at speed, I tell you, man. There's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
He puts it up at the horn. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Gonzaga wins and reaches the end of the road. These are the last road games of the season.
Hey, two wins are all they need, Mr. Nestler. And it's all they're thinking about as this team advances to the magical Final Four.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler. Good night, everybody.